Hello, and welcome to Urinary Tract Infections for Dummies. My name is Miss UTI, and today we'll be learning about urinary tract infections, or commonly known as UTIs. So, what is a urinary tract infection? A urinary tract infection is an infection that occurs within the urinary system, which includes the urethra, ureters, bladder, and kidneys. Now that we know what a UTI is, let's talk about what population is affected. Women are at a higher risk to develop UTIs in comparison to men. Interestingly, on average, Canadian women make about 500,000 visits to the doctors per year due to a UTI. In cases where the infection is left untreated, the bacteria can potentially move to either one or both of the kidneys and cause an infection. A major factor that contributes to the prevalence of UTIs in women is their anatomy. Women tend to have a shorter urethra than men, which allows it to be closer to the anus. When women wipe from the back to the front, bacteria found in the anus travels into the bladder and thus causes an infection. Other risk factors include sexual activity, types of birth control such as diaphragm or spermicidal agents, abnormalities or blockages in the urinary tract, or simply a suppressed immune system. Now let's dive further into how a UTI occurs. Improper wiping, sexual intercourse, and unhygienic sanitary products can give rise to bacteria such as E. coli. This bacteria then enters the urinary tract through the urethra, starting a UTI. The bacteria travels through the urinary tract, causing infections along the way. A UTI can progress in 5 stages: colonization, urepithelium penetration, ascension, pyelonephritis, and acute kidney injury. Here's a visual representation of the bacteria's path for you to better understand its mechanism of attack. Stage 1 is colonization. Bacteria colonize the periurethral area, which causes infection in the urethra, also known as urethritis. The bacteria then slowly ascends upwards to the urethra and makes their way to the bladder. Second stage is urepithelium penetration. The bacteria attach to the bladder epithelial cells, causing cystitis, otherwise known as an infection in the bladder. Bacteria then replicates and increases in number in order to penetrate the bladder and form a biofilm. Stage 3 is ascension, where the bacteria ascends towards the kidneys via the ureters. Bacterial toxins may also play a role by inhibiting peristalsis, meaning reducing the flow of urine. Bacterial ascension or hematogenous spread, which infects the renal parenchyma. This results in an inflammatory response called pyelonephritis, which is the 4th stage of a UTI. Continuous inflammatory response results in interstitial edema, interstitial nephritis, and ultimately the 5th and final stage of a UTI called acute kidney injury. As mentioned, the severity of a UTI gets worse and worse as the bacteria ascends upwards to the urinary tract. Therefore, it is necessary to treat a UTI early on in order to prevent harmful conditions. Now let's discuss the symptoms, treatment options, and methods of prevention for UTIs. The symptoms for upper and lower UTIs are different. For lower UTIs, the symptoms include frequent or urgent urination, as well as pain or pressure above the pubic bone. Symptoms of upper UTIs typically happen with lower UTIs and include pain and tenderness in the upper back and sides, fever, and chills. Treatment for UTIs typically include antibiotics. The type of antibiotics that is prescribed depends on location, severity, and type of UTI. A urine culture is typically needed before prescribing antibiotics. The duration of treatment is usually between 3 to 14 days. There are different methods of prevention for UTIs. Increasing fluid intake, drinking more cranberry juice or concentrate, avoiding anal intercourse, avoiding the use of contraceptive measures like spermicides or diaphragms, urinating after sexual intercourse, and taking one dose of antibiotics after sex are some ways that you can reduce the chances of contracting a UTI. Now, why is understanding the topic of UTIs important? As previously mentioned, it is the most common outpatient infection. The infection has a 50 to 60% lifetime incidence in adult women, meaning that this is the percentage of female individuals who will have the disease during their lifetime. This illustrates how widespread the infection is throughout the population, and thus it is an important topic to understand. Research shows that women who suffer from frequent UTIs have their quality of life impacted. This shows how great of an impact the infection can have in an individual's daily life. Furthermore, UTIs typically respond very well to treatment. If left untreated, the infection can spread throughout the body, becoming more complicated and dangerous. For example, if the UTI spreads beyond the bladder, reaching areas such as the kidneys and ureters, urosepsis can occur. This serious complication requires immediate attention in order to avoid a possible life-threatening event. As a result of the risk of hospitalization due to UTI complications, these infections are associated with a significant burden of care on affected individuals. Well, that brings us to the end of our lesson on urinary tract infections. We hope you learned something new, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button.